What is the deal with Ellie? Is she one of the few who's actually immune to the marker signal? Let's find out. What is going on, guys? Glad you clicked this video to watch. Before we get on our topic, if you're new here, why not subscribe to my channel? Seems like people are enjoying it, and I could always use some more comments to respond to. Alright, so anyways, enough of that, back on track. Ellie Langford is something of an oddity that not too many people stop to think about. She seems like your average woman, average person, average human, but looks can be deceiving, it appears. Ever wonder how it's possible that Ellie spends so much time in the presence of the marker, yet she's still able to maintain her sanity? Yeah, me too. I've got a few ideas as to why this is the case. First though, we need to know if there's anything biological that would render her special. Ellie is a 31-year-old woman at the time of meeting Isaac. Her homeworld is Earth, just like ours, and she possesses blue eyes. Well, eventually one of them ends up green, but we'll get to that shortly. She is going to be a Class 4 heavy equipment pilot, but apart from that, nothing seems too special here. So perhaps it isn't her physical biology that makes her resilient, but the mind herself. The time that Ellie spent in the presence of the marker signal appears to be much more than that of what a normal person could do. But how much time did she spend there exactly? Ellie has her first encounter with the marker signal in the events on Titan Station. Upon her arrival at the station, the marker has begun to transform everyone shortly after it is completed. The signal spreads throughout the colony entirely, causing everyone to begin the process of transformation. Ellie and her crew quickly abandoned their duties and began to seek a way out of the facility that they were stationed at. As they cut and slashed their way through, other crews began to track her rig to safety. Eventually, however, she would ultimately be the only one left, as Caleb, who had made it through the entire attack with her, sacrificed himself for her to make her escape. Being the lone survivor, she would continue on. At some point, she met another person who said that, you know, they would be able to help. Unfortunately, the insanity had spread to this person as well, and in that time frame, they attempted to kill her. She was successful in escaping, obviously, and would go on to meet Isaac later, albeit their meeting was hostile and she didn't trust anyone approaching her anymore. Eventually, she found Strauss and radioed to Isaac. They will continue on all the while under the effects of the marker signal. Strauss completely goes insane and ends up removing the eye of Ellie, while Isaac struggles with visions of his dead girlfriend. They eventually find a ship, and Isaac goes on to destroy the signal in his mind. Ellie picks him up right in front of the marker, and they fly away from Titan Station. All in all, let's say that was about a day spent in the marker signal. After the sprawl, Ellie and Isaac got into a relationship. It is short-lived, however, as Ellie approaches the subject of Isaac dealing with his past, and obviously it's having an effect on their relationship. Isaac decides that what's in the past is better to stay in the past, and Ellie ends up leaving as he would not face his problems. She would continue to fight the marker as her eyes have been opened at this point. Eventually, Ellie would meet Robert Norton and John and Damara Carver. She would go on to form a romantic relationship with Norton, but eventually this would come to a quick end. Before that, however, Damara, Carver's wife, would find some information on the Sovereign Colony's experimentation with the markers. They ended up believing that this was the source, and Ellie and her team would go on to begin an investigation into this information. I'm going to give you the short and sweet version on this one. During the events of Dead Space Liberation, Ellie arrived too late to save Damara from being killed by Jacob Danik, and Damara was eventually turned into a necromorph. Ellie went on to talk to Carver and said that she needed a data stick that contained the information Damara was working on. They met up and drew Danik out. Necromorphs and Unitologists began their attack, obviously not working together, for a necromorph is just a free-for-all unless you're a necromorph. Anyways, so they eventually would escape and make a blind jump into space, losing contact with Eudora. This left her stranded with her and her team, so they eventually would seek safety aboard the CMS Roanoke. So not CMS Roanoke-y, but CMS Roanoke. Alright, anyways, this whole timeline would have a minimum, probably left her exposed to the marker signal for a couple of hours. Then we come to the whole reason I even wrote a script for this video, the events of Dead Space 3. Ellie was stuck on the CMS Roanoke for about 2 weeks with her crew. Eventually, Norton, Isaac, and Carver would show up on the Eudora and attempt to perform a rescue mission. Unfortunately, it goes completely sideways and not so hot, but you know, it happens. They ended up locating leading her very quickly, but to Norton's dismay, she wanted to stay as she believed that the marker's homeworld was right below them. She believed that they could stop it at its source. So after cobbling together a few pieces of some other ships, they would go to land on the planet at a massive loss of the crew, however. I believe 2 people die, maybe 3? It's a little fuzzy. So the ship basically shears in half, and Isaac and Carver are on the front part of the ship, and Ellie and Norton, and I believe 2 others were on the back side of the ship, and I should know their names, but God help me, they die anyways, so spoiler alert. So they kind of just get reunited later. The unitologists show up and begin their attacks. They show up because Norton is kind of a jerk and calls them. But anyways, Norton gets shot in the face trying to stop Isaac, so he kind of gets his. Isaac, Carver, and Ellie go on into the facility to find Rosetta's lab, but as it turns out, it's the Rosetta slab. They continue on, learn about the markers and the moons, and realize this is just another planet in a long line of planets that have faced utter extinction. If you would like to see what causes the extinction, I actually have a video on the Brethren moons, and it should be up on screen right now. So either click that now and then come back and watch the rest of this, or just stay here and it'll probably be at the end screen. Danik gets the key and descends into the planet with Isaac and Carver hot on his tail. Isaac at this point believes Ellie is dead, so he is basically seeing red and descending as fast as possible. However, Ellie is not dead, and later she gets captured by Danik. They all meet on top of the machine, where Danik turns off the machine and restarts convergence. Ultimately, via DLC, causes the human race to go extinct, even though we should have had Dead Space 4. All in all, at this point, Ellie spent about 2.5 weeks in the presence of the marker signal. So, now that we are all caught up, anyone notice a trend here? Consistently, Ellie has been exposed to the marker signal, and consistently, she has maintained an immunity to it. I know what you're thinking right now, but Roanoke, due to the audio logs, we can see that smart people see symbols and letters while the less intelligent go insane. And you know what? You would be half right about that. The more intelligent an individual is, they will see ways to kind of build the marker and make sense of the symbols that they are seeing in their head. However, the less intelligent are driven mad by what they can see. There is a caveat, however. The smarter individuals will, while at a slower pace, still go insane. Even Isaac, after getting on the Ishimura, only lasted about an hour before he started to show symptoms of insanity that brought down the ship. When Carver lands on the planet, he also begins to see toy soldiers and people running in the snow. Basically, everything in his past begins to come back to haunt him, and you actually have to do a mini mission that is modeled after Dead Space 2, where you have to go inside Carver's mind and you have to destroy the neuron that is replicating this signal. So anyways, back on pace. The fact is that there is something else at play here. A theory was raised that it is mental trauma that allows the signal to flourish. If you didn't know, Isaac actually had a rough childhood, so this would fit the bill quite well. However, after Ellie watched her whole crew get torn apart and have people basically try to kill her multiple times and watched her relationship fall apart, she's bound to have some mental trauma from some of these events. So it is my opinion that mental trauma doesn't work either. So what is it then? Well, let's discuss how the species evolved. In the universe, human evolution was brought on by the marker signal, kind of like guiding it. But that's the key. It was only guiding, it wasn't causing. Animals had existed quite a long time before the black marker struck Earth. This would mean that the animal cells had already become a thing and already had a plan in place genetically for where they were heading and leading to. While maybe not sentient, but an individual animal with its own thoughts, needs, wants, desires, and instincts. When the marker hit and wiped out the dinosaur, the mammals became the dominant species. So that chimpanzees share 99.5% of the DNA with humans, but it's our 0.5% that makes us completely different, where all of our intellect comes from. So let's say that in the 20% of the DNA coding, at the very front, I guess front of the line, that's where the resistance to a marker signal exists. But anyways, while this gene may not be expressed in most humans, due to a random chance, some of the species would exhibit a resistance to this marker signal. Think of it this way, we've evolved on a planet to coincide with multiple different microorganisms, yet still, some of us will die because these microorganisms will actually kill us if they can get a foothold in our body. In fact, my whole job is predicated on learning and hopefully stopping this from happening. So our body created an immune system to fight the invading organism. The strength of your immune system is also largely based on health, but also genetics and immunities received from your mother at birth and by breastfeeding, no less. But also in a symbiotic relationship, other microorganisms aid in your actual immunity as well. Let's focus on the genetic portion of this though. The genes build the immune system into stopping a foreign object from controlling you. At some point, the genes of a certain animal stop the marker signal from controlling it. This passive immunity still exists in some humans, but it appears that it has been lost and never really developed in some genetic lines. The line it appears most strongly in is the most intelligent. While some may only be slightly resistant and eventually will go insane, others have a much stronger response and are actually immune to the signal itself. For instance, did you know that there is something called the Delta 32 allele? It is based in Central Europe, and it is believed that because the Black Plague swept through that area and killed a bunch of people, it changed the alleles of these people. And now these people, I believe if they're homogeneous for this allele, they have a much greater increased resistance to the HIV virus. Even if you're heterogeneous, you are still very resistant, much more than the common person. So I believe that this is what allows Ellie to continue to thrive in the presence of the marker signal, yet still show no signs of alteration to her mental stability, unlike literally everyone around her. All right, guys, so what do you think? I want to hear down in the comments what you think about Ellie's immunity to the marker signal. If you like the video, then please like and subscribe. It's free, and I think I'm actually starting to hit a stride here a little bit, with more coming out all the time, so, you know, you want to just go ahead and get on board for that. I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, I will see y'all in the next one.